Hi Jyoti sir, welcome to the show. How are you sir?
Good. I'm good, Jignesh, and thank you for having me on the show.
Thank you for your time, sir. Your budget has been liked mostly by the street, everybody participating in the street, and we have seen a significant rise in the market in last 2 working days. What is your reading on the budget, sir?
See, the budget has been a positive surprise and a pleasant surprise to the entire market participants. The key was that, you know, earlier the government was being very heavily criticized so that they were not spending. But if you look at this budget, right now, people were, with a, increase in tax revenue, you see as the economy has rebounded very strongly in third quarter. So people were expecting that the government, is going to spend the 30.5 lakh crore rupees of budgeted expenditure during the year. But what has happened is that the government has surprised everyone and have said that they want to do a total expenditure of 34.5 lakh crore for FY21. So, and fiscal deficit, people are expecting that the government will, try and maintain fiscal deficit at around 6.5 to 7% for FY21 and around, 4, closer to 5% for FY22. But the government has clearly announced its intent that it is going to spend, very aggressively. And the fiscal deficit, as you all know, is 9.5% and, 6.8% for FY21 and FY22. So markets have been, that extra almost 4 lakh crore rupees of spending, planned spending during FY21 is what has really surprised the markets positively. And that is why we are seeing such a big rally happening in the markets.
Right. Sir, the next question is, do you think the valuations getting justified here, or do you think there is a in next couple of quarters at least the corporate earnings will justify the current level?
See, I tell you what, to a large extent, this what's happening in the market rally is not only a factor of this budget, because prior to this budget, we have seen a correction in almost 7-8% on the Nifty, and so that was predominantly on account of slowdown in global flows. Now, because of this budget, what is going to happen is global flows are again going to remain strong, at least in the foreseeable future.
Right.
And that is something which is going to provide a tailwind to this market, especially in the backdrop of this budget. Now, next, we'll have to monitor what's happening in the US as far as the second stimulus package goes.
Okay.
The Democrats are trying to push for, while earlier they had passed a stimulus package of $900 billion, the Democrats are pushing to increase it to $1.9 trillion. But they need 60 seats in the Senate to get it passed. So they are trying to reach to some sort of a compromise with the Republicans. So that is again going to be, a key focus area for the government. So instead of $1.9 trillion, if there is any significant delay in that second stimulus package, being enhanced to whatever 1.9 or 1.5 or 1.3 billion trillion dollars, then that can have an adverse impact on the, any negative news flow on the that the second stimulus package in the US can have a negative impact on global markets and global flows. So in a way, if like domestic factors are now positive, the Q3 earnings season has also been relatively good, especially BFSI. On the BFSI side, the asset quality stress is not, half as bad as people have thought even after the Q2 earnings. So there's a significant relief for the markets on that front. And that is also what is driving the market. If you look, Nifty is also being driven to a large extent by the BFSI space, BFSI sector, because they have a very large, almost 35-40% kind of a weight on the Nifty. So we believe that overall domestic factors are now positive. Clearly the only factor to watch out for are going to be global factors and global flows.
Right. Are you looking at re-rating your budget, your yearly targets for the Sensex and Nifty?
Not really, because see, even when Nifty was, not immediately, I would say, probably we'll wait for these global factors to settle down, and then once we have more clarity on how the global economy is going to shape up, especially in second half, over the next couple of quarters, that is when we'll relook and revisit our Sensex and Nifty targets for, let us say, FY22.
Okay. After the budget, your sector allocation will change for the clients, or would you
No,
advise
actually, you see,
differently?
see what we had done is even prior to the budget, just prior to the Q3 numbers, because we were more than the budget, we were focused on the Q3 numbers, we had shifted allocation. Like in the, we had increased the allocation to the BFSI space. Right now we are at market weight. While we don't own any PSU names, but we do own a lot of private sector BFSI names, banking and NBFCs. Then along with that, even in the auto space, we have moved out of two-wheelers and we now have tractors and passenger, commercial vehicles. That is our preferred space. Plus on the, consumption and industrial and the industrial side, we continue to remain overweight. So we had made these changes to our, our sectoral allocation about a month back, like at the end of December, beginning of January, for the Q3, earnings season. And the Q3 earnings seasons, have, sort of indicated our stance, that, we are on the right track. And the budget is actually just the icing on the cake, if you ask me.
Okay. So, net-net, if I were to ask you, any other sectors that you are underweight right now?
I think from a part of view, we have reduced the weight in the IT space. That was, during the Q3 earnings season. So we have reduced the weight in the IT space. We don't own anything in the FMCG space. So let us say we are right now currently tactically we are underweight on the defensive sector.
Okay. Okay.
Overall. IT, of course, we continue to remain equal weight. We are not underweight. We continue to remain equal weight because we believe that it is more of a growth story. It's just that, market, there have been a significant run-up in stock prices. So, probably it will, after the significant run-up in, December and January, probably they will correct for some time, consolidate for some time before they again start moving up.
Okay. So, if I were to ask you personally, how would you rate the budget on a scale of 0 to 10, 10 being there?
I will give it a rating of, 9 out of 10.
Oh, that's very generous of you. Quick 3
No,
points.
Because honestly,
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
No, I think quick 3 points that you liked most in budget.
I think if you really ask me, one, there was no major adverse, tax on a move on the taxation front by the government. While whatever they have done at the margin here or there, I mean, that is okay. But I'm fine. There has been no major adverse move. Even the steps, if you look, has been done in such a way that, it's not going to make any major difference. It's not going to have any adverse impact on anyone. And if you ask me, the third and the final thing is the spending. I mean, because see, we didn't have any expectations of tax cuts or, I mean, I don't know, a lot of, I think actually most economists didn't have any expectation of any tax cuts or anything. It's just that there is no adverse move on the taxation front, and the government spending of 34.5 lakh crore for FY21 is huge. I mean, yeah, what probably, on 30.5 lakh, if you look, 34 lakh crore, I mean, which is again the same, the FY22 spending target from 30.5 lakh crore, that's a huge step up. And a significant portion of that spending, the additional spending is going to happen in the fourth quarter.
Correct. Correct.
And that could be some spillover to next year as well. Of that, I'm sure.
Correct. Very true. So, thank you so much for your time, Jyoti. Looking forward to have more such conversation over a period of time. And
Thanks a lot, Jignesh. Always a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Bye.